Hey, what's going on? It's your boy J-Pap back again with another video. Today, NBA video. I know you guys like these. I know you guys been getting a lot lately. We're going to keep them coming. We're going to keep them coming. The playoffs is in full swing. First round is nearing the end, and I got a lot to say. There's a lot of crazy matchups. There's the surprising outcomes. There's some disappointing players, and there's a lot to talk about, and I'm just going to kind of give my thoughts so far on what's been going on in the NBA playoffs so far. So let's just get right into it. Here is the updated bracket. Here it is. I think only one series is over at the time of this recording, the Timberwolves Sun series. I'll get to that. I'm just going to kind of go through every round and give my bold topics on what's been happening. You know, Thunder Pelicans here at the top of the West. That series, I thought would be a little bit more interesting. I think I had the Thunder winning that in six. Obviously, the Zion injury, no one expected. I don't know. The Pelicans have talent and depth, but it's just not clicking right now. And the Thunder have its extreme chemistry. Thunder are just a better overall team. I think Zion would have made this a very, very interesting matchup. I think the Thunder would still win, but I don't have much thoughts on this. The Thunder are going to move on to the second round and get a tough test, whether that's with the Clippers or the Mavericks. They're going to be tested a big time, and Shea is crazy good. I mean, this next series here, Clippers-Mavericks, this is the one I was the most interested in, and it seems like it's the best series of the first round, which I knew that would happen. The series is tied up 2-2, and the Clippers destroy the Mavericks in game one. Mavericks come back and win the next two, and then now the Clippers just won the most recent game. I'm very impressed. Like, without Kawhi, the Clippers are playing super good. Like, Paul George is playing good besides that game three. Harden has been really good, which I don't know how that is happening. I don't know how the Mavericks are allowing him to be this good. The Mavericks should win this. Without Kawhi in there, I don't know if he's going to be back. He's definitely not healthy. The Mavericks should win this game. Like, I don't know what's going on. Like, I'm not a Mavericks fan, but the Mavericks should win this series. That's all I'm saying. The Mavericks should win this series. Now, here we go. This is just so crazy to me. Timberwolves already on to the next round in a sweep. They brought out the brooms. They said, come here, KD. Come here, Booker. Come here, Bill. Come get swept up. Come get swept up, buddy. And they did it. They fucking did it, man. I thought this would be a seven-game series, at least six. I thought it would be super, super tight. I was wrong. I didn't see this coming. I thought, like, I don't know. I feel like if you have the talent of the Suns, like, almost the chemistry doesn't have to be there fully. You should just – the talent should get you through a couple games. The talent alone should get you a game or two at least in the series, and this is not good. Like, this is not good for the Suns. I'm going to talk about the Timberwolves in a second, but – you got, you know, you have KD still in his prime. D-Book's still in his prime. They're all in the prime. Obviously, I don't like their bench. I think the chemistry just of the overall team wasn't there. But Devin Booker, you went to the finals without KD. Like, this doesn't make any sense. I think whenever you make a trade for someone like that, like, obviously they got rid of Cam Johnson and Mikal Bridges, which I think was a lot of depth for them, and three-point shooting. And I think it's just not working out right now. They probably should have kept those guys. Timberwolves look great, though. Their defense is great. Anthony Edwards is a superstar in the making. They have the two centers in Kat and Rudy Gobert. Like, their defense is amazing. They have depth. They're a scary team. Look out for them. Like, Anthony Edwards is only 22. Kat's pretty young. Like, they're going to be a scary team. And the way they just sweep the Suns, like, with ease like that, that's scary, man. They could make some noise in the second round, even if it's against the Nuggets, man. Like, don't count out the Timberwolves. I'm not counting them out. That'd be crazy if they make it to Western Conference Finals. But that was a crazy series to me. Next up, we got Nuggets, Lakers. Now, this series isn't over. At the time of this recording, I think Game 5 is tonight, which if Lakers win that, send it to a Game 6, would be insane. I think the Nuggets are going to finish the job here. I think they're going to finish the job in Game 5. I mean, everyone knew the Nuggets were the better team. Everyone knew that, but people just wanted the Lakers to win based off LeBron, loving LeBron, and, you know. Because let's be honest, like, if the Lakers are somehow beat the Nuggets in this series, Timberwolves would be a tough test, but if they can beat the Nuggets, they can beat the Timberwolves. On to the Eastern Conference, Celtics Heat. That I did not expect the Heat to get a game there. They stole a game in Boston's arena. I think that's a wake-up call for Boston. Wake-up call that they need to stay locked in at all times. I think sometimes they get comfortable and allow the other team to kind of get confidence and momentum. And the Celtics will most likely win in five here. Most likely win in five there. I think there's not much going on in that series. I mean, the Celtics are and will and should beat the Heat and make it to the next round. But the Heat always give them troubles. There's history there from 3, 4, 5 years back. There's history. It's a rivalry. If Jimmy Butler was healthy, man, I think this would be an interesting series. Just because of how good the Heat are against the Celtics. The Heat just play good against the Celtics. Like, it's just, they play good. Bucks against the Pacers. Indiana is currently leading 3-1, and I don't even know where to start with this series. I picked the Bucks winning in, I think, 5 or 6. I had no idea that Giannis was hurt going into the... I don't know if he was hurt going into the playoffs or not. I guess he was. So that kind of explains everything. Then Dame gets hurt last game. Portis got ejected. There's a lot going on in this series. It just all depends on if Giannis can somehow get his ass back onto the court. Even then, I don't know if that's going to be enough. Like, is Lillard going to be there? They just have too many question marks. Even, like, Doc Rivers, like, I could very easily see them losing this series. I mean, they're already down 3-1. Like, they're going to have to win 3 in a row just to get out of the series. That's going to be tough, man. That's going to be tough. This Pacers team is fast. They're young. They have chemistry. They have a superstar in Halliburton. They got Turner. Don't forget about Pascal Siakam, former Raptor. Like, being in the playoffs is a lot about being healthy at the right moment, you know? It's a little bit of luck. You can't deny it's luck, too. To win the playoffs is luck. And the Pacers are getting that luck, you know? The Pacers are getting that luck, man. And now, unfortunately, this is the sad part of the video. My Sixers currently down 3-1 to the Knicks. This has been a crazy series. Like, I've watched every game of it, obviously. Super physical, super back and forth. It's a very even matchup. I think crazy thing is Joel has been, I feel like, been getting more into, like, his shape and conditioning as the series goes on. Like, he's been playing better as the series goes on. So, like, that's why it doesn't make sense that we lost that last game. That was just a terrible fourth quarter. I just don't think we should lose the series. Like, we stopped Brunson to, like, less than 30 points the first two games, and he just, like, erupted like a firebomb, and he scored, like, 39 and then 47, like, some insane amount of points. You can't do that. You can't do that to Brunson. You can't give him that confidence. Like, I think we can win. I think we'll win one more, and then probably, I mean, you never know, like, We gotta win game 5 in New York. That's tough. But if we can somehow do that, come back to Philly, I think there's a better chance. You know, I don't know. You never know, you know? Like, Josh Hart's been playing crazy good on the 3-point line. Like, it's just a weird series. They have no one to guard Embiid. Hartenstein, weird name, weird looking guy, and I'll tell you what, he's not guarding Embiid. There's some big problems with Embiid's health over the last 5 to 10 years of the playoffs. Like, he just hasn't been able to stay healthy when the time counts. The Knicks are a good team. Like, I knew this would be a tough series. I'm not saying I thought we would sweep them or anything. Like, I knew this would be a good series. The Knicks are a good team, scrappy, play really good defense, play hard. They have a star in Brunson. We need Tobias to be productive. Tobias has to be productive. That's kind of what's hurting us. Batum has been quiet. We haven't had a lot of production from our bench, and I think that's been hurting us the most. Final thoughts so far in the first round. I think the Celtics and the Nuggets are on a crash course. They're both on fire, and they're both trying to meet in the middle at the same time. Like, who can meet first, you know? They're on a collision course for the finals. I think it'd be a crazy finals. I think they're definitely the two best teams. You could say the Clippers, Mavericks, and Thunder also up there. Even the Timberwolves, like, all the teams in the West have a chance, but I think the Celtics and the Nuggets are the best teams. They've been the best teams all year, and they've been the best teams in the playoffs. And it's going to be interesting to see. The Celtics have an easier path to this, to the finals. Like, they're most likely going to go up against the Magic or the Cavs, and then probably the Knicks. Like, come on now. And then the Nuggets got to go up against probably the Timberwolves, and then probably like the Thunder or the Mavericks. Like, it's a tougher test, yo. It's a tougher test that could play a factor in the meeting in the finals. Like, the Celtics might have played way less games at that point, you know. But that's going to be it, y'all. Hit that like button. Make sure you hit that subscribe button. I'll be here in a couple days with another video. I'll see y'all next time. Peace. Yeah. Seven 30 in the light.